It's true. Are you sure it's the same place? Try to invite somebody that has not been here for 2 years. It's mind-boggling. But do you know what people do when they are in the middle of revival? After a while, they forget it's revival. Like when the glory crown was over the children of Israel for 40 years. After a while, they forgot. They started gossiping and challenging. And the Lord was there. It's not having a negative effect. Sometimes when you are in the middle of, after a while, people get used to it. They forget when they were crying. Here is the message God gave me for a bonus stage. It happened, I made this discovery many years ago. I've been in ministry for years. And I was trying to understand why, what's the purpose for this calling. I say, like a man of God, whatever, you can abuse that. What is the purpose? Is it for me to succeed? Is it for me to drive more cars? What exactly is it, my own breakthrough? And so I began to ask the question, what's the essence of life? Why am I here? Why did God bring me here? Why did he anoint me? Why did he give me this platform? What is it? What did he call me? In the course of that, certain things that Jesus would say began to dawn on me. For example, one day the two brothers were quarreling over their father's property. And they came to him. And one said, tell my brother to share the property with me. Jesus said, who made me a divider? He said, beware of covetousness. A man's life does not consist of the abundance of what he has. That shattered all mine. Because I'm from Anambra State. Every young man that grows up there wants to make a lot of money, build house and all of that. And that was my dream too. I don't care. When I was begging God, I don't want to preach. So I can go and make money. When he refused to accept 20% tithe, I made it double, 40. I said, please leave me alone. I already have a plan for my life. I'll be giving it the house at 20. I know those ones are men of God. Kumu in 20. I couldn't convince him. Let me tell you what it was. So I got into ministry, but that quest also succeeded. Followed me. I'm an Anambra boy. I'm not going to come back here. I'm telling you, so look at my cousins. They're building houses. But now I meet this junction where this crisis of purpose, knowing why I'm created, why I'm even in ministry. And I began to cry to God. He said, go back to the teachings of Christ. And that's when he directed me to scriptures like this. And then, here is what shocked me. He said, a man's life does not consist of the abundance of what he has. And I said, oh my God. If it doesn't consist of what he has, then what does it consist? What is the essence of life? And the Lord showed me, gave me understanding what I'm showing you now. He said, look in nature. There is nothing in nature that exists for itself. Nothing in nature exists to serve itself. Nothing in nature even consumes what it produces. I said, explain, sir. He said, look at the sun. The sun labors non-stop 24 hours, produces solar energy. But the sun never consumes solar energy. He said, why does the sun produce all this energy? Millions and billions of quantums of solar energy. For about 9 planets, for planet Earth, for vegetations, because all the plants every day are depending on this guy up there for their photosynthesis so they can produce food. The animal kingdom depends on the sun. You and I will be wiped off the faces of the earth if that man up there, I'm calling him a man, fails just for 1 week to carry out his purpose. The earth will become a frozen planet and all life will perish. The Lord said, look at the rivers. I've been to the source of life. Some tourists took us there. You see the ground pumping water. If you go to the source of River Niger, from that mountain where it's pumping water. In my house, I have water pumping machine. I installed it and we have borehole. But this one, God put it, natural. All these millions of gallons of water. Have you ever seen with Elijah drink water? Have you ever seen and tested and did what I want to do? Why is he pumping out all this water? Because human life depends on it. This will travel to how many countries, how many states. The plants depend on it. The success of agriculture depends on it. The animals, that's where their sources. If that man, that river, holds back his purpose for a couple of months, there will be disaster in the animal kingdom, in the plant kingdom. It ends up affecting society. If the Lord said, look at the vegetation. Have you ever seen a mango tree with all the thousands of mango they produce year after year that eat mango? He said, everything in life exists for contribution. Everything exists to serve something else. He said, the essence of life is service. You miss it, it never existed. You just merely pass through it. Is whatever you need, whosoever you need to talk to, he exists to serve you. Have you ever seen your car? Some of you came with cars here, you parked it. He will stand there waiting. He won't say, let me go for break. He won't say, let me go to market and buy something. He won't say, I need fuel. No. God doesn't bother about that. What he exists is to serve the owner. When you are out of here, he will be there waiting for you. He goes where you want to go. And that's why he doesn't need to fight for fuel. You keep buying all the fuel he needs, repair it when it's broken down, fix it because of the service he's rendering. When a car stops moving, serving, you see it on the roadside, and even armed robbers will not be willing to steal it. No armed robber wants to steal a bad car that is useless, that doesn't work. But hear me, ladies and gentlemen, everything that serves has another thing that serves it. You see this phone that serves mankind? There's something else they put at the back called battery. The battery serves the phone, so that the phone can serve human beings. By serving the phone and the phone serving human beings, both of them combine to accomplish that purpose. Now somebody said, it's only the battery that serves. There is also something that serves the battery, that serves the phone. It's called a charger. It exists to charge this battery. There is also something that serves the charger, that serves the battery, that serves the phone. It's the socket where you go to get that thing charged. There is also something that serves that socket. It's the wire that connects it to power. There is also something that serves that wire. It is the generator or the source of power that supplies electricity. Do you know that the whole generator standing there year after year till it dies, just like cars die, phones die, generators die, one day it will be your turn. What you'll be remembered for is your contribution. The essence of life is contribution, not consumption. It's not how much you take out of life, it's how much you contribute to life.